So there were a bunch of areas where, like, here I am at the Great Wall. I had to shoot some of my own footage when we were over there. So I would, you know, take one of my... And there's some definitely beautiful areas that we got to go through. I get to walk through, you know, alongside this path from this private... There's this private hotel that you stay in these rooms and look at my nice camera moves. It's good stuff. I mean, they're pretty buildings. Many of them put together very poorly, unfortunately. So if you look up close, they're not that great. But there's you know, some newer stuff that had been put in. And some people were trying to put in a slightly better version of things. A lot of lacquer, a lot of heavy shellac on particle board wood. That's my 2018 when I... climbed the wall again. I went up to the... This was a mock-up, a brass mock-up of the hotel area near the Great Wall that I filmed that's supposed to show like an aerial shot of where we went. And then you go up, you stay in these different hotels that are designed by different architects. And then these are all these guys. They were all coming up behind me because I was way faster up the hill. And this is, you know, a private section effectively of the wall that we went to right here. And you hoof it up to this. And then at this particular hotel, they would bring a table and stuff up. These guys would hike up with backpacks on with like a table and chairs and food and fridges and all that kind of stuff in the back of it. And then they would set up this thing. And you could, from this restaurant, you could have dinner on the wall overlooking this part of it or whatever. Meanwhile... See if we can see this part right here. Yeah, this is me and one of the other crew guys sitting behind this chunk of wall up, which is at the top of the other side of this area. See that fence right there? You climb up this wall. That's what that path I was on, where I got way ahead of everybody. They still weren't up there, so I was just taking footage. I was trying to catch them in this part of it. And this is, you know, this is a shot of the wall. The land's very lovely. Looks kind of like Kentucky, but there's big chunks of the wall and they're constantly fixing it. So even though it is the Great Wall, there's so much of it is not the original stone. We went to kind of the highest points. We did drone footage up top of there. And basically, this is one of the, what I was sent, I literally sent a picture to our director who wasn't a big fan of Chinese food. Like, they have some in the hotel you can eat. There's our crew. I miss those guys. Some of them I can't even contact anymore. Now you know why I've got a chip on my shoulder about the CCP right now. People were lovely to work with. It's our sound guy. Like, there's, you know, it makes me nervous even naming some of them because we were just, that's our director. There you go. This was footage of us. Oh, so in China, they outlawed Peppa Pig because gangsters were getting tattoos of Peppa Pig on their back because the province they're all from looks like his head. So the government literally, I think this is just a fake picture because some dude being gangster, but they literally, guys were getting Peppa Pig ones. Everywhere we went, there was always some dude with a bunch of shit tied to the top of his vehicle. Walking around, there are pictures, renting bikes. I love these weird statues. This is what I call Tetris Plaza. We did a workout in this one particular thing. I had to put on, they have these weird exercise, companies that use electrical current. So you just work out and you try to stand up while they're sending electrical current through you, whatever. Like a lot of it was just, quite frankly, hooey. These guys, like, there's so many of these. So, let's see. That guy was a fashion designer. This is a Chinese statue in this one place you could go to. It's so weird. Look at the weird, like, dude smashed up against the, that's so weird. These are these kids that were all competing at this private school we went to. There's a lot of ghost cities. It was a giant cup of coffee. It was we went to this huge, opera house, which, you know, was gorgeous and had all this giant stuff in it and no one else. Like, these are amazing buildings with nothing going on in them. I mean, some of the party gatherings happened in these locally, but that's the only thing. They don't allow a lot of performances. I was all over this place, man. This is this Dutch dude who runs a, or a Danish dude, he runs a bakery. This guy Gertz, he was a really nice guy. Really good food, makes his own bread. The sourdough that was, we were in Sanlitun. The bread that, yeah, there's his, I was getting B-roll of this thing for the show. That's his grandfather brought over this sourdough yeast that he uses in all of his stuff. Yeah, pick up some fairly good B-roll when I'm shooting. Yeah, and then this was on the newspaper when we came over there. Again, one of the gatherings that they had together. Conference marks 200th anniversary of the birth of history's number one thinker. The English version of China Daily. This is in our hotel. Let's see, where else do we go? No. Some tea. Lots of tea. There's flying and being on trains and being asleep. This was mooncakes. These were some of the signs that I saw that were fantastic. No laying inflammable thing. I was like, I could just have a job over here helping them translate signs. No burning. Okay, no burning. How was this a TV show? Your phone? Yes, it was. It was a travel show. Warning danger. Warning electric shock. Oh, and Miss Hal's cake, which was some store we passed. There was a place called Miss Hal's Cake. Like, they were closed. I didn't get to get in there. Feiyu is the shoes I used when I was training in Wushu all the time. This is our, like, I was like, oh shit, there's a shop. I bought like 4 pairs of Feiyus while I was there. There we are. I sent that picture to my buddy. There we go, just walking around shots because they needed stills for some of the stuff. These are these canals. Oh fuck, this was so funny. These guys... So you could get in these little boats and motor around with no license or anything. And so they just get jammed up and they were just all fucked. They were all, like, at one point this dude got stuck and this other one tried to go around and there was like 6 boats in here and they couldn't get past him and everybody was honking. It was super funny. So much of this stuff. Yeah. It's one of the markets we were in. And again, like, understand, we were in these places and these were the busiest streets we saw. And still, you could walk around with your arms out, not bump into anybody. And I was and this is a tourist destination. So this is not just the place itself. This is, and these are some of the food from Gertz's bakery. Let's see. Hold on one second. Yeah. So, this one dude made, we went and saw, made, kites that had moving parts. This is this old lady that I met, and she taught me how to do sculpture. She kept making passes at me. It was hilarious. She was all, she's all flirty. This is some of our crew. This is the, I went to see the Terracotta Warriors. Again, here's another area, big shopping district. In a city that allegedly has 30 million people in it. Supposedly 30, remember, this city alone, this one, I think this city we were in had so allegedly 22 million people in it. Yes, that woman pinched my butt with great frequency. The old lady, she was great. The shops were largely empty, and there was a lot of people walking around, and see this dude right here, this guy right here? These are like these old uncles, these part of the lost generation between the sort of communist uprising and the modernization. And these guys walk around kind of just watching everybody. They're like government, they're like freelance government snitches. This is not suburbia. This was basically center of town. Hal doing his handsome man face wherever. I was trying to do my propaganda pictures, Wes. And there's food on display everywhere you go. Just opulence and stuff. I did Peking Opera. They dressed me up in Peking Opera to show you what you had to go through. So I had to go through the whole process of getting made up. That was fun. Hi. It's a good look for me, don't you think? I look like Eddie Izzard. Yeah, those dudes were freelance snitches. That's what they are. And they're everywhere, the old uncles. Let's see. I know I have a bunch of videos. Because those were the pictures that they sent me. And then I have my channel. That's it. Let's see, places. Yeah, so here, hold on. Bring this in. This is by no means all the places we went through. This is just the stuff that I have on my own stuff. These are places we went. There's me at the wall. This is one of my favorite shots. This is while we were just waiting with the gear. I just sitting by a wall waiting for shots. My silver shoes went everywhere. This is me stretching here, like all these different places we went to. This more shots on the wall where I was just walking around taking my own pictures, the staff taking pictures. Oh, this was this place where we went for breakfast. This basically like this street, this lady invented this kind of like hot breakfast dish that's very popular in the area and everybody lines up to get it. This was this giant chair. I was like the end of the table. I had to send them pictures of what we were doing. To like where we would shoot. Here's Shanghai and Jiangxing. So much stuff. There's me with a bunch of pigeons taking pictures. There was lots of pigeons, like more pigeons than people in some cases. I was so tired during some of these because the travel was so odd. And again, big city, 30 million people, billion people in the country. Imagine being in a city in Thailand and it being having so few people around. To me, sitting, getting ready. This is where we went to. I went to Shanghai Disney too. So I got to. I went to Disneyland. One of my Masonic brothers, works for Disney Imagineering and got me tickets to Shanghai Disney. Best thing about that, Tron ride. I took a couple of members of the staff with us. Yeah, they went and then some people recognized me from the States. That was fun. Suzhou and they have all, let's see. We don't really have, let's see, minus. There we go. So here's Xi'an. Oh yeah, here you go. Open this up. There you go. There I am. See that wire? That's the only thing attaching. Yeah, there was no lines at Disney either. Seriously, I didn't stand in line for more than 8 minutes anywhere. But please tell me how China has billions of people in it. Somebody was telling me earlier, like, they have like 3 billion people. I'm like, are you high? They don't even have one. You hang locks on there like the bridges, but I did that whole walk. You move along and you unhook and then you rehook past every seam. I have some other pictures. I'll have to find them. And I have my 360 camera with that. But there's Xi'an. We were in some pretty far out places. Here's Chongqing. We were out on the street in Chongqing with a bunch of the folks showing us around the nightlife areas and whatnot. Good times. And we filmed in all these places. And we do not, thankfully, if you'll notice, in the area around Wuhan, they kept us fairly far away from there. I'm just sure if I have, does this have my, hold on. I have to shrink this out a little bit. Because I've been all over the globe, kids. Some of the pictures I took were before Hungary, the UK and Ireland. A lot of my pictures I took on my old phone and stuff before there, you know, this, you can tell this is like iOS era, right? But yeah, this was right in the lead up to COVID. I was all over China, taking trains back and forth. We're in Nanjing here. Lots of photos from Nanjing in that area in Shanghai. Yeah. Good stuff. So I think some of my photos shared out. Maybe that's what it is. Yeah, here you go. Hold on. This guy right here. Oh yeah. All right. So this is some of the shared like BTS footage, pictures that we were shooting there. Some of our Chinese crew, you know, some of the shots I took of folks, some of the stuff they took of me while I was filming, you know, food. Oh shit. Ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Okay. Check this out. All right. It's a little blurry. I'll see if I can download a better copy. This is our meeting with the propaganda ministry. This, that dude in the middle is the propaganda minister for the CCP. And the woman next to him was lovely and working very hard and doing a great job, but she was very nervous because she was worried that if she mistranslated into English anything that that dude said, she'd be in deep shit. But she was very pretty, so they used her essentially because they thought that would be, that would dissuade us from, you know, in our behavior or whatever. And I've talked about this meeting. This is a picture from that gathering. And then we took a picture afterwards. Look at this shit. We had to get all, I got all suited up for it. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's him. There he is. Jesus. So Forbidden City. This is a this is an old chemical plant that they turned into an arts district. Really cool looking. Be amazing to film there. We did film there. Thanks. I'm glad you like the suit and tie. I bought it over there because I didn't have one. Luckily, I'm the sizes are good for me over there. Let's just say. And we filmed this fashion. This guy's a fashion designer in this area, and it's like we're looking at all this stuff, and it's all like they're saying this is an architectural firm that this guy's an architect. And we were talking about the sort of architectural standards, and they were following me while I was talking to him. There's the crew over there. There's me discussing, you know, my dad's an architect. So we got into, a lot of the conversations. This is in the area where we went. And then they, of course, send you for a duck dinner. It's kind of standard fare. And then they put you in this really fancy room. And yeah. Oh, this is the electrodes. This is where I had to exercise while being shocked. And this is the lady, she owns like four of these. Yeah, so these are all shots from, there's the Great Wall. We did two trips to the Great Wall. Everybody touching it, we hiked to it. That's the area, I had to let them know where I was. So I had a radio for all the places I went. And this is one of the buildings. This is the bamboo one. You could stay in this one. You could they created a Friends. There's a, this is from Friends. They made a Central Perk in one of these places, and they had pet cats running around, and it's a total ripoff. They play Friends. Everybody wears Friends shirts. The whole place is based on the architecture and the furniture of Central Perk. It's a coffee shop. It's in a mall. Then we went to the Blue Note, watched this jazz musician play. Don't get me started. This is another designer. This dude was like crazy. This guy, he was fun. We had a good conversation. But he uses an old form of design, and he basically makes like emperor level clothing. So we did a big to do, you know, like, because it was a travel show, and, you know, it's a shame that all this stuff went away, because some of it was really interesting. Parts of it, it was clear they were pushing us in a direction to try and give us an image of the country that was nothing short of bullshit. At the time, and it became increasingly obvious the more time we spent there. It's one of our producers. Oh, all right. So this is one of the, let's see if this plays, hold on. So this is this big library. It's an amazing library. Look at this place. It's incredible. It's a big giant ball. Hold on, let me shrink this down so you can see more of it. I mean, it looks gorgeous, right? Whoops, hold on. Picking up footage of me walking in the place and walking around, right? This is our kind of B-roll of me walking in. the books right here are real. On either side of me as I'm walking in. Little ones that you can check out. The rest of the place, all fake. None of these books are real. Obviously, these ones up here aren't. It's just for show. But none of these are real. There's two rooms off of here we went in, and there were no books in them. Again, this is a tourist spot. And can you, I mean, if you've ever been in a museum in New York City, even on an off day, the idea that it would be this empty is ridiculous. The books are fake. It's a display. Everything is a display. This is an unfinished tower. We're like, oh my God, look at the thing they're building. Never finished it. Went to the movies while I was there. There I am making dumplings with a hairnet on. Oh, guys, remember when I mentioned this on one of the shows I was on about the bullshit eco city, right? This is a display of all the garbage goes in this way. And the lights are where the recycling goes into the green things. And they're putting these containers and the containers are driven away. And you could just go to this. There was a display of this actual spot. The Tianjin Eco City, where everybody is just like there's a zero carbon footprint and yada, yada. This was the market that I told you we went to with the seven dwarfs on one side and then the Chinese mythology on the other side and then Mickey Mouse and Donald Duck are in the center there. Seriously. This was where everybody lived in this area. They have all these flowers. There's a market down here and over here. And in the market, there's no cash. You just go in and use your app or whatever. That's Superman, and then that's Peter Pan and the Seven Dwarfs, and it's super weird. I don't know what the fuck. It's super weird. It's absurd. This is supposed to be a city, the eco city they're building, full of people, right? Those are the only people we saw the whole time we were there, walking around. There may be eight others. This was one of the hotels we stayed in. There I am asking if I can go behind the scenes and help them make dumplings. This is us getting shots and stuff. Like the quality of what we were shooting was very high. Hey, there you go. Look at the books. Look at the books. Look behind him. These people are watching us. See this dude up here? That's a government snitch. This dude sitting with his legs spread. You can always spot him. Just like they always, if you see them outside, they always do the Beijing bikini, which is they pull these dudes with their shirts pulled up over their belly, just walking around smoking. This dude is just watching us. But look at the books. Look, it's just all benches. There's no books. It's supposed to be the largest library in the world, and it has no books. These are all fake. These are all fake. Those aren't real books. These aren't real books. It's none of it. All of that is just art. It's just painted for paint's sake. That's me interviewing these dudes at these schools. This is me stretching. We interviewed these folks about like e-pay, paying for everything, using your phone. Basically, this was an interview about this in this one shopping district in this little apartment place, which was totally empty too. Fucking hell. Like I'm forgetting like just how, like these are tourist areas. In the biggest tourist areas in China, during the biggest tourist times in China, and you could spin around without touching anybody. There I am. They're hooking the electrodes on me. There's so much. This is just like a mix. There's Gertz again, the dude. He was a really nice guy. I miss some of these people, man. It's a shame. It's a fucking shame. Like, this is one of the biggest crowds. And this is because we were shooting, walking through. And so more people came. So as we shot more and more people walked over to look. And so we walked through them while they were filming. And then other people would just watch us as we did it. And we're like, guys, that's not how this is supposed to work. We're just walking around. Disgusting. Oh, So this is the ecosystem downstairs where I went, right? The little, where I was looking at how the eco city works. We went downstairs and they had an area where you could walk through and look at shit. And every, yeah, and there's him going, this is all bullshit. Like, I was like, I'm climbing on this thing. That's when I just climbed up and the thing was concrete. None of it works. None of it is, like, we saw the mini version of it and then we could walk around and there's plants around because you're supposed to tour this. This is for tourists, like from the world over, from Africa and India, to sell the Belt Road Initiative. They fly people over from other countries, walk them through this, go, we can build an eco city just like this, like it's fucking IKEA. And when we were walking around this, you could go, like, you could see it. It was like, oh, look at these pipes and all this shit. Nothing's happening. And I went downstairs and I was like, it's all fucking concrete. And then this is a store. This is kind of like the Amazon store where you don't pay with. Is this interesting to you guys at all? I don't know. This is just me. I found these pictures. So I'm now reliving this whole experience. But you go, you go in this place and you buy shit. And look at all these pictures covering the fact that the upstairs stores are all empty. But you go in here and you go through this little like airlock where you walk through and you pay with your phone and then you leave. So it was like, oh, we've got stores without even cashiers. I'm like, motherfucker, it's a communist country. There's no situation where you don't have extra people to work. Why would you ever want automated payment systems in a country with too many goddamn people? You know what I mean? Like, that was always the joke about communism is, you know, you pay one guy to dig a hole and the other guy to fill it in because idle hands of the devil's workshop. Meanwhile, here's what they're showing us. Here's where I would go down. Like, every so often we'd be filming and I would just break away and shoot some alleys. I would just slink down. Like, look at this. They were shooting this guy. They would show us how the whole, like, these flashing lights and, you know, like, this is where the garbage is going. And these are the units as they put their trash in. And it's all bullshit. I had just walked over and looked at the containers that was supposed to take the garbage away, and they were concrete. They were not tanks at all. So where are these tunnels, these tubes going to? And this is from the lady that filmed the breakfast thing, and I went in there, and there's a huge line to buy her breakfast things in the morning. There I am in line. And I go up, and I get one. And we go back behind her place, and I help make some for people. And then we eat it together. It was brutally hot. Oh my God, burn my face. Very delicious, but ridiculous. This is us all having dinner that they threw for us. They do that all the time with foreigners. They corral you into one room out of the rest of the restaurant. That's also very fascinating to me. And it became increasingly clear as we were shooting that they would give us these private banquet rooms in some ways to keep us from eating or being filmed or filming around the other people that were in the restaurant. Like, you know, a lot of times I was like, let's just go down and eat in the regular restaurant. And they would put us, this is 2018, 2019. The last of these pictures is right before the end of, this is the bridge. This is this dude's place. We met this Chinese billionaire, God help him. The real voyage of discovery consists not in seeking new landscapes, but in having new eyes. Marcel Proust. This guy had this really super modern building, and he does all this architectural stuff, and he's teaching people, and it's really beautiful inside. However, and they have a school, and we went around to the school. This guy's an architect. He's been working in Shanghai for years. He bought a couple of key pieces of architecture, and he makes a living there. He's one of the dudes, I don't want to get him in trouble. He's a nice guy. I talked to some of the the school, how they do their schooling there. This was obviously a display too, like a school for show. This is where I met with the billionaire. We had a conversation in his private viewing room. So that's them setting up the shot. She's me. There's the, you know, There we are talking to stuff, looking at all this. This is the area that he invested in and built up. And oh, so this is like very touristy again. This is an area where everybody wants to go. However, Shanghai. Let me look this up. Hold on. Let me do something real quick. What's the population of Shanghai right now? What do they say it is? 24 million people in Shanghai. 24 million people in Shanghai. New York City has 8 million. We are filming in a city that allegedly has almost four times as many people as New York City. And by the way, this is in a both tourist and foreign business friendly area. Lots of people. That's in Shanghai. Les Suites Orléans. There we are at the, like, and look at all those buildings. Lit up, oh my God, right? 24 million people live in this area. There I am. I had a really nice fancy dinner. That's the night I got food poisoning. That's the dude who did it. Gave us a pizza, made me sick. Here's some foreigners we had dinner with. What's it like living here? Yada, yada, yada. All largely flown over. This is where we go. This is what I'm shooting. See what I'm getting at? They send us to places like this, all very manicured. 24 million people in this city. Think of the size of this skyline, which is enormous, in comparison to Manhattan, for example. 24 million people. We are on the Bund right here. The Bund is the walk around on the tourist side and the highly populated side, for that matter, of the Shanghai Bay. And where the fuck is everybody? Oh, did I say four or three? Yeah. Yeah, thank you. That thing was just sitting there, so the fun we had. We got on one of these boats. I toured the entire fucking thing. We went out in it. I did a bunch of stand-ups talking about Shanghai and how fast they built this shit up and how that river was created through the damming of other rivers. They work nights, yeah. This is us getting on a train in Shanghai to go someplace else. 24 million people. 24 fucking million people. Let me see. Grand Central NYC Interior. Hold on. I shrink this down. Here you go. Dreamtime, New York. There you go. That's Grand Central Station, New York City. A city of 7 million people. 7.6. This is a city of 24 million people in the train station. The train station. This was one of the best parts. We went to this place on the outskirts of Shanghai where, I mean, they obviously fabricated and corralled these people, these old craftspeople, into one area to make it a tourist destination. But they had these old looms and people work at these things and they, you know, it's like this fabric is made the old-fashioned way. And I sat at one of these looms and I spun thread and I watched them do it, and they put on a big show for us of that's, you know, they make these lanterns. So like, it's like a like little Etsy stores in a lot of ways. Everywhere we went. That's me and the crew rapping in Shanghai. Oh, this is this winery we went to where they had a secret. You go and you pull this lever, and behind that cabinet is a secret entry. And this guy was like selling us like the best wine and yada, yada. Okay. So these little bridges are in that Shanghai area, and you can rent a little boat and you can kind of go around the entire area. And this I thought was, this is what I, as a tourist, would want to see when I go to China. Hal, are you concerned the Chinese government will come after you because of how you're exposing their facade? A bit. My more concern is that I can't go back anytime soon and see friends and do stuff, but it's just not worth it. You know what I mean? Like, you, at some point, you just gotta, it's heartbreaking, but morally, it's the only way to talk about this. Like, this stuff was beautiful. Like, this whole area. But, and it's a lot of old buildings mixed with some new recreations, and some of it's fake and some of it's real, but they refurbished certain areas. That I don't have so much of a problem with. Yeah. And then this is one of the hotels, and there we are at the Starbucks. And this is this old building, which looked like the Ghostbusters place. This is where we did the, there was the, I'm like, how much lead paint are we standing around? This is where the winery place was. It was behind one of these fake doors. And that's the day, that's daylight. That's the daytime thing. We went to the president's room. There's a big picture of Teddy Roosevelt and Theodore Roosevelt in there. What was this guy? Let's find out. Did I have my list?
Welcome.
Oh yeah.
Explore China.
Let's go. Oh yeah, this is like one of the early demo.
It's intense. Let's go. There's never been a better time to explore China. Let's go.
That was the yeah, that's what we're doing.
We're not even to the top yet. If I had it to do all over again, I'd do KEMS tomorrow.
Let's go. I went to a club.
It's absolutely worth it for the view. Let's go.
Yeah. I was far more known than I thought I was over there. That's the other thing too. So this is another like drive-by shots of stuff. We went to this like I'm going to get a copyright strike for playing this thing or whatever, but like just kind of the nightclub scene there. And these restaurants and that kind of stuff. And again, like I'm talking to like foreigners and expats and stuff. And after a while I would get to this whole thing. I'm like, I just feel like I'm being led around by my goddamn nose. Like, I love a lot of the stuff, and I love the Chinese culture stuff. Went to these night spots, went to see bands in these, like, one little rooms, and people paying with their phones and whatever, and, like, these guys were hilarious. It was like, whoops, I didn't mean to open that back up. Here you go. These guys, I called them Chinese garbage, and not because of actual garbage, but the band Garbage. They sounded like the band Garbage in Chinese, which I really enjoyed. This is that hotel we went to. This is people high in a club. This is the like bottle service and all this shit. And where it's a gay friendly part of Shanghai, which is, you know, a little bit of nonsense. The food on the night markets was pretty great. That's me getting my own breakfast. These guys on the street would do this. I went across the street and got this myself and filmed this that little segment myself. Yeah, so there's another like copy of that. A couple versions of extra footage. So much of like what we went through in these places, is it coming? Hold on.
Right here.
It was, you know, on the one hand, I had so much hope about it because I love the Chinese culture and I have a lot of Chinese friends and I've studied martial arts my entire life and, you know, and then to go like, here's the boats. So all these boats would start heading into this area. And I don't know if we caught the footage of that. This was at night. I got this footage. There's like a lot of like open air karaoke places in this that were very noisy or whatever. This is all me making dumplings, how to make the dumplings. These are some of the hotels we were in, which look gorgeous. There's Gertz again. That's our shooting permit, which we had to get and have with us at all times, or the weirdos would come after us. Some of the places we're in, like, incredibly beautiful as far as the architecture, all copycat Amsterdam stuff. This is the reggae bar. This dude, his whole bar, his accent, everything, it was all reggae. Like, he got into reggae. He's got dreadlocks. They're pulled back. There they are. You can see him kind of in that shot. And he was talking about how, like, in China, like, if tomorrow somebody goes, oh, the thing is Greek. Everybody likes Greek stuff. By tomorrow afternoon, everybody would have Greek clothes, Greek haircuts, Greek stuff. And they would just do that. There we are. Walking through, me and Gertz. He's interviewing these folks. West Alcohol Playground. Welcome. With the Vegas sign, the knockoff Vegas sign. So shooting in the Forbidden City. A lot of them giving a shit about that. This big opera house. Everybody hiding while I was doing my walk arounds. Me on the stage there. Prawns. Me getting mic'd up at this. And this was a school we were filming at too. Okay. One of the most crowded places we went to. Day after this. And still, like, once you walk past this little area, still not that many people. Yeah, so I'm going to go back the other way because we were watching this direction. Yeah, so we didn't get to go. We were me in these hallways. I mean, I would, if I could get access to this footage, I would recut this whole show on a documentary about how, like, China's been bullshitting the West and India and every other country, for that matter, this entire time. If I didn't think it would get the crew and everybody involved in trouble, because that's the sad part. I'm not worried about me. It was us taking off, man. Yeah. I don't know. I also have footage of our, at one point our, let's see. Let's see. I'm going to have to look it up. And I sent it to Summer, but our, while we were in one of the cities, I think we were in Tianjin, it was in Chongqing. Our bus driver, our driver for the van that was taking us around to film, was snatched up by the cops and disappeared. They just came and grabbed him. It was friggin' crazy. Some people may remember years ago that I posted the video while I was there. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know that it's... Did I put it in my Dropbox? No. Yeah, I'm gonna have to look it up. But it was... crazy. Beijing, yeah. Oh. Well, here we go. Here's some of them. Well, let me see if maybe this is in here. Let's see. Let's see, this is me on that cliff again. Bink. They're filming behind me. See how they're holding stuff up? And they're like, they haven't ventured out onto the cliff part yet. It was freezing. There's me and the Terracotta Warriors, and there's this dude who stands outside in an outfit. It's very weird. I think I'm shirtless in some of the other ones, so we'll skip past some of those pictures. Oh yeah, there's a bunch in here. Oh yeah, okay, hold on. So... this one, is there like some of the pictures I took? That's me in drag from, that was just added. I think I posted something. That's that industrial area. This like EMS stuff. Some of the stuff that I've already shown you mixed in, but then there's some of the other ones, me in my little jumpsuit. There's us on the wall. There's more of the place. There's that dude. There's the central perk. There's the Blue Note. There's this, the guy interviewed at the library who did not know what he was talking about at all. This is one of the alleys. This is us eating together. This is where they recreate. This is a house made out of like reclaimed bottles. Birds. Shanghai. Oh, it's Disneyland. That's us in Disneyland. So. Oops, it froze up. Hold on. Hello. I'm staring at you with one big eye. There you go. Yeah, absolutely, Maria. I'm just glad we came upon these. Yeah. Oh, and this is a influencer I met with in Shanghai that I did an interview with as well. Oh, and there's this giant thing of garbage that was in front of us that was incredibly colorful. It's like all cozies. Here I am working the looms. This is that area I was talking about that where I rode the boat around and all that kind of stuff, which was really nice. I took some of these photographs because I like the shape of them. Let me see if I can find another one. Back up. Oh yeah. These are cool. Hold on. Oh shit. There you go. These are fun. So, pandas. That's right. I went and saw the pandas. I blew up some footage of these, but I got to feed the pandas with like apples on a stick, and we have footage of that somewhere. But that's all the pandas, you know, that place. That's us going to see the pandas as we're eating panda. No, I'm kidding. I did a cooking class thing, and then I was like, oh, look how nice everything is. But this is me getting my Kwan Gun painting on at this one particular place. They wanted to dress me up for this thing, so they found out I have a giant Kwan Gun statue, so they put the Kwan Gun makeup on me. I look like I have a big mustache right there. It's good. Mm-hmm. It's frozen. Hold on a second. It's got to wake up. Want to hug a panda? I don't think so. Do you like Chinese ancient opera? Yes, I like Chinese opera. I do. Are they changing the votes for 2020? Yes, that's what they're busy doing. Right. Hold on. Might need to restart or something. It's being weird. I think it's trying to load a piece of video, so I don't want it to hang up and not show us. Can I sing? Like a bird. Oh, here we go. All right, now it's working again. Let me see if I can jump ahead to... Oh, that's why. The reason I set this up is we did it with time-lapse. This is with my camera, so I... And they moved in. I'm like, guy, did you put your head away? Yeah, there we go. And then this was us taking it off after I had to go back and film everything. Squiggle, squiggle, squiggle. Squiggle, squiggle, squiggle. Get the thing. And I had nice eyeliner the rest of the day when I was doing all that. So, good times. Ta-da. All right. And then I'm finding all this stuff. Hold on. Oh man. This is amazing. So we went to, Chongqing, like I said, which is supposed to be 35 million people in that city. Hello, Melbourne. Hey, Peter. Good to see you. I'm by the way, I can't, like, I've never, lately, I've been wanting to go to Australia even more. Like, my new three places that I need to go are Italy, Ireland, and Australia, and not in any particular order. This thing is downloading. All my pictures from Chongqing are downloading. I'll see if I can. Okay, check this out. See this bridge? See that bridge? They're building a bridge. What's wrong with building a bridge? Building a bridge is awesome. You can have traffic on the top, traffic on the bottom, right? Look, there's lanes for down here and there's lanes for up here. I mean, nobody told these buildings. Nobody told these people. Or even that there should be a road on the other side. I'm not kidding. This is not going anywhere. Still not done to this day. Oh, wait. Is this
moving?
Mm-hmm.
I love reading Shakespeare.
Us getting, like, trying to get footage of us in the bus.
Left on a deserted island, you can only have one book, what would it be?
It's after food poisoning when I'd lost all my facial weight because I was croaked. Okay, so let's see. That's the I was walking around. There's a lot of this is video. I just like that. I was like, oh, I'll make that a symbol or something. This place with old electronics, the old electronics market, and they just you can just walk around. We filmed in this area. Oh, I got a I got a fake tattoo on my back. At this one place. So we had to get pictures of it. I got a nice V taper happening. It's not bad. I don't get to see my back very often. It's actually quite nice. It's all right. There's that place we went to. I played Mahjong, by the way. That's what that is. I cannot figure out where this bridge is going. It's not going up, and it's not going through. And that's a historical site, and there's that much room, and it's that huge, and that I don't. What the hell? Does it go down? Like, they knocked off the top of that building since the last time I was here, so they're still building on it.
Yeah, we came back to this place another time.
I don't get it. They're not boring through over here, unless it's going to be a walking bridge. You know, it's just. They're just going to put stuff across it, or...
I mean, there's a train station right there, so maybe they just stop right there and put in stairs?
We could not figure this shit out.
What would you do with the top?
Right, and why wouldn't you just make a smaller walking bridge? This is a double-decker... this is meant... You could remove a battleship across this thing. I don't get it.
We were so fucking confused. Even while we were there. I think it's just footage.
It doesn't look like it.
All right, so wait. Which side of the river is that? Is that our side?
No.
That's the picture of what it's supposed to be.
That's the other side.
Well, maybe it is. Look, that looks like the satellite. That looks like the historical site over here.
Yeah.
But it doesn't look like that. It looks like a regular bridge. It doesn't have a walkway or train thing to, like...
Mm-hmm.
What the hell is that?
And there was nothing under the ground for it to go to. Super weird. We were all just so like, shit. They're gonna flood the area. Oh, that's possible. Let's see. I remember. Memories. Like the corners of my mind. 2016. I'm trying to find a specific. Date period to show you something. 2016, 2018. Oh, yeah. There you go. Well, let's see. Yeah, that's just BTS footage. It's okay, but there's more. Hold on. I'm scrolling through some stuff to find
these particular dates. Here we go. We went to this place where they film all these movies. And like all these old kung fu movies. And some of you may have seen me post this picture on Instagram a long time ago of that plane. It's just sitting in the middle of this thing. I guess they tow it out if they don't need it, but it's basically just there all the time. These are these old catapults. The camel I was riding. We went to a temple. This is a real temple. There's a little tunnel you can go through. And if you go through the tunnel, when you come out the other side, the Buddha will cleanse you of all evil spirits. So I went through there. I lit some incense. And don't let the fact that there are swastikas in the footprints upset you, because that's just part of the symbology of that area. And then we went and saw this big show about the beginnings of this area. I can't remember. These are just the pictures. It was an amazing kind of like tourist show, and you'd wait through and they would like, there were more people in the cast than there were in the audience. A lot of people, but still, we saw it a couple of times. This is the... So he does this monologue. This guy does this monologue at the beginning. Yeah, Blue Hal Group. And let's see. Beijing. I'm trying to find one particular. Yeah. July 2nd, 2019. No. Hold on, July. Ugh, so much stuff. What's this one? It's just a tuk-tuk and some small stuff. I'm sorry, I fell into a memory hole for just 1 second. Memories. Sorry, I can't show you all this stuff as I'm doing it. February 1st, 2019. That's right. Jiaxing. Lin Tong. Road to Huashan. Here we go. Yeah, this is some fun stuff. Hold on. So, this was cold. There's Prince. Prince died. The places, like, we drove up into the mountains to this place we were going to hike up through. And this is where we got to... Yeah, the only thing we could find to eat for our director. Then we got in this rail car. And then we get up there. And we go up to this thing. and you walk through this thing, and again, we're, yeah, this should be, this should have the picture of the, does this have the monkeys? We had to hike all the way up here. It was a long way. It was very cold. By the time I got to where we were shooting, and we were doing, you know, stand-ups about stuff, I was in, I ended up shooting most of mine on my own phone. I lit some incense, as I'm wont to do whenever I pass a temple, get used to the idea. We go out to this one place. You can go this way. You hang by peg on this thing, which is fun. Hope it's still, it's loading, I think. Hold on. Unless that's the, yeah. I think these are videos, some of them, and they're still loading. Yeah. But the mountainside was pretty beautiful. Wind burn, little wind burn doesn't hurt you. Oh, I look like I'm singing. Yeah, you hang by pegs in the wall, in the stone wall. Yep, here we go. Well, I think most of these are, yeah, they're loading. So here's some of the videos.
Okay, almost to the top.
I was booking it up this hill.
Every time you think you're done, there's another set of stairs like that.
Yeah, this is all like that. Yeah, good stuff. I wish we had, you know, let's see if I could find. Yeah, it's still loading. Yeah. Yeah, there's, here's the picture they take of you. Got a tether on my chest, and I'm holding on to that wire, but that's pretty much just, it was fun. Everybody else was all nervy and weird about it, but our crew was really nice. And then you had to, once you come across the whole thing, oh, that was a French dude. There you go. This is, I think this might be footage. And I'm like, eh. Trying to rig myself up as I go. And look at the quality of the strap. Like, I've got these two carabiners, but look at the strap that's holding me to the carabiners. It's just nylon, and it's just a knot, just a small knot. Like, who gives a shit about the straps around your shoulders or the carabiners or what they're being held against when it all boils down to this part? Look at that. This is like, it's the stupidest. I'll see if it comes up in a second because it's hung up for a minute. You're getting you're getting vertigo from just that. Yes, Velcro. Yeah, a bunch of this is just it's downloading, so it'll take a minute for it to get there. But you know, as I was doing the show, that's probably right when I was starting to go, I feel like we're being corralled. I feel like this is kind of bullshit. Right? That was right about the time. No, we didn't go near Mongolia. We were going to. That was on the list. And yet, these videos are long, so that's, it's 85 of 127. It's downloading all these pictures onto my so much of this, I'll you know, that'll do it for today, but I'll show you more of it in the future. I'll download some of the bigger parts of these things and we can kind of go through them, but so much, because it's already 11:30, so much of my experience over there was like really like wonderful and positive and all this, and the people were really nice, and then we get in this situation where these assholes like just could not help but make it worse for everybody. From the government standpoint, you know? Yeah.